Michael, drive safely, huh?
Okay.
I keep getting those guys' names wrong. Austin and Dylan. Yeah, Dylan's the big tall guy. Austin and Dylan. Dylan, Austin, and Kevin. So what happened?
A player control foul. He'll need to take a look at it.
Okay.
He called it in like the midst of rotation, which is always tough to do.
Oh, that's a, yeah. All right. During the rotation as the lead, there was a player control foul. So Kevin, take a peek at that.
You said Jerry Holm?
Yeah. Well, I knew he had something going on tonight. I said, Tom, we'll put him early and he can drive home and take care of his banquet. He had a late 17:30. Yeah. Yep. Kevin, you had started a rotation as the lead at about 17:30, and you probably could have not go through the rotation, just step back, go back. A charge with the shoulder?
I will. Well, it depends what level we're talking. In a women's game?
Probably. Well, not at your level.
No, that's a bigger one. In a low-level women's game, the girl probably ends up on the ground.
Correct.
Although, it really depends on the game and the coaches, too, depending.
It wasn't a lot, but it... could have created a disadvantage that.
Down it.
No softball today or anything back home?
I'm not doing that this summer.
Oh.
They, their season, because their high school season went so late, they didn't. The summer is like, they're doing like all days on Sundays, and I don't like it.
Yeah.
And it's only by yourself, and I don't.
A I one like, person?
Yeah, I like doing the play part because I like to see pitches. That's what I. But I don't like chasing the kids down at Scheel every other time and run out to second base and try to make a call from. That's stupid. I can't tell.
Yep.
I don't know if he's safe at all.
Got him?
I do, actually.
At 13:30, Kevin had a call on the baseline.
I'm the last one he saw on that puck.
You bet. Good job, Austin.
Here we go, Black, right here.
This side, yep. Sitting down, I feel like I should go to bed.
I don't know why. Usually I'm up till 2-3 in the morning on these every but not.
I woke up at 6, I peed, and I went back to bed, and I got up at 7, I went and had breakfast with Greg.
Greg's a nice addition to this. He's very knowledgeable.
Greg is. You know, and the sad part is the veteran officials, that like that one guy that worked for 20 years, Jerry Ming said, that man was bad. I said, yeah, there's a lot of them out there. They don't want to listen because, oh, I've been doing this for 20 years, so I'm not changing.
I keep getting my schedule for the last
year. Exactly. That's because they got to give them games. Yeah, he is. You can see it. Kevin. Right, sir. Okay. That is. That is a college mechanic at bouncing it. High school you wanna bring them back over there. What's that?
You're not saying that we bouncing it to the other side of the lane though, are you?
At college that's elite, that's what they do.
Always bounce here and then just yeah. There for the trail.
What'd you yeah. Say that? I didn't hear you.
That's a college mechanic bouncing it,
yeah.
Which is good. That's what you're trying to learn.
These guys here for
yeah, for me. Yeah, they want to be picked up. And it's hard for them to understand that, you know, it's a high school camp, but yet I want to see college mechanics.
Right.
Which, bouncing across to you, you don't give a rat's patoot. As long as the ball goes where it belongs.
Right.
We had a play where they had a violation. The ball should have been out by the freeze line extended, and their crew gave it down here on the baseline and flipped it up to the big guy, and he got 2 points. So that's an advantage game for the for the other team.
Right.
So we're talking about that shit. Just like your game. A lot of stuff happened that you might have lost the game, but there was calls and on-calls and things that happened, and the foul count, everything was going against you. Everything. Then they missed the call in the corner because they didn't open up the field of vision. And you're down. I said, you were down by three or five.
Down by three. It was 30,
and then
30.
And then shit broke loose.
Yeah.
I saw that. But they didn't. You like the bend elbow or straight up?
He's tall, he should still be like that.
He still should? Well, that's my point. He's tall.
He's
should
here. He needs to be up.
You still think it should be up? All right. You think that's a lazy thing? They have these bionic bodies nowadays.
I don't know if I ever had a body that bounced up as quick as some of these kids do.
It's hard to tell from here if that was a foul or not.
Nobody argued, no one complained.
Because the kid went backwards with the shot. The offense didn't push him backwards. His body just went backwards. But it's hard to tell you the camera should pick it up. Yeah.
He's pretty new. He's done some high school in the past.
This guy's from Madison, right?
Austin's a Madison guy. And he's the other guy's from Chilton area.
Where are you? Kevin.
You're Chilton. I'm actually Dwight. Like, I am born and raised in, like, Dwight and South.
At 6:15, the coach is complaining about a charge. Well, he didn't have quite the angle I think the official had.
I think it was an offensive foul.
Listen, the elbow was like this. It extended out and went like this. It was just like that. It wasn't this tucked in elbow. It was out. The chicken wing came out. I think it was a good call. Now, was it vicious? No, it wasn't vicious.
Doesn't matter.
But this is legal. That's illegal. And he brought it out. And the kid went backwards.
And it's game.
Yeah.
They're playing good defense. They're playing better defense. They're staying in front. They have a nice team.
And we've talked about this all weekend, about if that official has a chance to talk to that coach, coach, this is legal. You bring it out, that's the charge, and the kid went backwards. Well, the white team's got a 9-0 run right now.
The key at the halftime is to remind our three here that they can't miss the offensive foul against white folks.
Yeah, yeah, like now,
you,
now.
You're 3-0, you can't miss them when they happen on this court. That's how you feel like you can stop. Even
yeah.
If you aren't, it's just the perception part of it.
Yeah, you gotta get white for the offense. Well, the other guy should have taken it, yeah.
But that's okay.
But he had a wide open shot
yeah,
to that reach.
He
saw it. He had a great look.
And it was, I'd say it's cadence to not be waiting long enough to get the chance. And we're going to be technical on it.
Yeah. That was a nice call, Austin. He had a good look from the sea. First. Good job. Good job, Dylan. Now, Dylan, that was a good call from the lead, but you walked away and didn't get the number. Just go a little slower, have the foul, make sure your crew knows you had a foul, and then get the number and then go to the table. Just be a little more patient. Remind me, I gotta take my jump drive out of that computer.
Okay. I'll remind you.
Thank you.
trick?
Yes.
Did you tell me in O'Connor that this is it? Or?
This is the last year. For my wife.
This is your last session then.
This will be it.
Well,
but
you'll be around, Mom.
I'm hoping my wife gives me a day off.
Even if she does.
We've had a great run.
Yeah, a long time. Going back to Lawrence.
2005? What year did you start?
That sounds about right, yeah. A long time ago.
That's the year I started as a college coordinator, 2005.
Was that at Lawrence? Were you at Lawrence?
Yeah, because Robus was the assistant coach there and asked me to do a camp.
God, it was hot there, too.
Oh, and then we were up in a swimming pool gym. All the heat? Oh.
Well, it was still, you're right, it's air conditioned, but it's still warm in there.
The swimming pool, it was moisture. Yeah. You went 1 minute?
Yep.
Again, I think we talked about it with you.
Yeah.
Only in the last quarter of the game that you want to say 1 minute left. Not quarter games, not halves. First half, I see lots of people do that. I don't know where they got that. But only the last minute of the game is the 1 minute.
Okay.
So just, again, what did I say? Get in the books. Study a page. Study a rule. Study a couple mechanics. And if you see it in the Federation book, tell me, because I haven't read it for a while, but I know it's not there. So, little things. Okay. Them are the little things that elevate your game through stuff.
So, what did you talk about? What'd you say to him so far?
The 1 minute at the end.
In the first half.
Okay.
Seriously, so your hand, every out of bounds, we don't just point it. You're stopping the clock. I don't care, but
It's a high school thing. The men have.
Oh, you're doing the men's stuff. No,
yeah,
no.
So he's okay. So that's okay. So.
What am I thinking?
Again, yes. So here comes Mark.
What are you seeing on these offensive fouls?
So on that first one right at the beginning, he put his elbow right up into his.
Yeah, good
right
call.
Into his face. And then with the charge, or with the offensive screen, there, you know, obviously wouldn't. Usually because I get his play interrupter, but he was right there and he did this.
Oh, he delivered the ball.
Yeah, right into him.
Yeah,
so I was
fine.
Like, I have to.
Okay,
sure.
Now, we just talked about it again, and we'll say it again and again.
We had three, though.
You got to sell it. But
one.
You got to sell every one of them.
Yeah.
But you got all three of you. When you have a big play like that, you sell that son of a bitch and you tell him.
I'm vocal. I'm really
loud. Oh, my God, he's way too loud. I heard him down the block.
When I have an offensive foul, you know it's an offensive foul. Because I'm that illegal, and I'm yelling illegal screen because I don't want there to be a question.
And I believe Kevin had one over here that was in the paint.
What I want to say about it again, let's think now, like a basketball player, or basketball team, or coaching. It's 3-0 on an offensive foul. White might not be doing anything, right? But we cannot miss anything against White if they do. You're not fishing, you're not looking, but if it's there, we can't be like, oh, because he's going to lose his shit if...
You call another one.
I mean, if it's there, if it's against Black, it's there, you call it.
Yeah.
But if White does something, we cannot miss it.
We talked
to Dylan. There's one in the lane, right here. He fouled first, and then the kid went like this and shoved him out of the way. You called the foul, and it was. The first foul was on Black.
Yeah.
The second foul... would have been, we could have punched it and shipped the other way. But
we talked about it in the previous game about the elevation of his blood pressure.
He's pissy.
He is now to the point where we have to be very careful.
He's really at you. That's who he's mad at.
Okay.
He's mad at you. You're trying to talk. You're listening to him. I'm not sure what you said to him. Nothing really.
I just said we're listening to you.
Yeah, you might want to just relax.
And I talked to him after that first
that's
one.
That's fine.
Yeah, but it's
the second one. And actually, it was the third one. And then he was like, that's three of them.
Mark was over there talking to us. And I went, Mark Miller goes, yeah, he gets pretty excited, doesn't he? Went,
so,
well, there's potentially there's a reason. But in the last game, you and I talked about that game,
yeah.
How it went to the dumper fast.
Yeah.
and the elevation of fouls. So it's the same thing with him now. It's the second half. He don't care. He just knows it. But don't make up a foul or don't make up. Then, call what's there and then sell it to him and tell him.
First offensive foul, here it came, and there you went. It's more believable if you're at a
you ready?
Stop to get it than to be like,
okay.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Giddy up.
I was looking and it was down, but. But see, you could see Dylan thinking, because the last game he watched it and he talked about it.
Yep.
I said, what you were watching in the first game, you are now officiating the same thing.
It. Yeah, he's doing it.
You got to realize that's what's happening.
I do. I think he was hurt some before he would be if that's the path he wanted to call.
Oh, yeah, for the men's. I was watching it, the kid got hurt.
I hope I didn't bait him into that one.
Well, you got your offensive foul in the white. And he's clapping, so.
I was just pointing out that it was 3-0 and we can't miss any. Maybe it was. I don't know. It caught me off guard. How about that?
So quick. Within a minute, he nailed you.
He's like, Waupun, you see, I got it.
Yep, that's right. Now we got 2 in a row.
Let's play Country Lutheran, right?
Yeah. Kevin's talking to the guy in the white. Yeah.
Mark, do you get a lot of the Madison schools in like that area at all?
Another one. Austin. Yeah, that's illegal when you have a rolling screen. They have. Yes, they have.
As the three of them, they've all found they're doing a better job now.
Yep, I agree. They're getting the calls they're supposed to get.
Mark, you
enough, we need to know what's the closest place for that spotted cow.
Oh.
Oh, from here?
Yeah. Casey's a good place to get it?
No. Get it at that grocery store, it'll be cheaper. Yeah, grocery store will be cheaper. Or go to the, you guys come up 57?
Yeah.
Right, the Supercenter Walmart, otherwise probably will have the beer there too.
Right here in Plymouth.
Right where, so if you get up, you go right out this high, the door here to the highway, and then up to the highway, there's the next real exit where like it goes down, that's Walmart. 57, it's there's the big right. Walmart. I'm, I am 99.9% sure that they sell beer in their store there, at that one. I want to say 100% because every Walmart up here sells beer. They will have spotted cow. Okay. They'll have varieties of new beers.
Yeah, that's closer.
Okay. And that's the easiest. I mean, otherwise you got to zigzag through town to get to the liquor store to Piggly Wiggly. I would go to Walmart.
Okay.
Otherwise, any gas station.
Take care of yourself.
I want any like bigger gas station on the highway. I'll have it.
Yeah.
In Wisconsin. All right,
Mark.
Hey, we'll see you guys.
All right, thanks.
Yep. Travel safe, guys.
You were the front or the back?
Front.
Go to the front.
To your benches, guys. Go to your benches.
He's doing it. Kevin's doing it. Get together. I had no clue. The big guy in the blue?
I'm not sure what happened, though. Yeah. I just had a drink. Like, undercut quick? Like, you went for a rebound or something?
I'm on the mic.
Oh. Mark, take this a second.
Yep.
No, now you get to listen to me for the rest of the game.
You got way up in the air and you just kind of got...
Well, legs went from underneath him. Did the kid, like, totally back underneath him in the air?
No. I mean, it definitely wasn't intentional, you know. Like, it wasn't anything. It's one of those plays. The kid gets up so damn high. He said it happens to me all the time. Well, okay. It's like a glancing type thing. Mm-hmm. He lost his balance.
Like most sports.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Most of it's not.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Kids that are invincible. They were flying in even though they had no chance to get the ball.
And I'll tell you what, my only complaint would have been over is that he didn't stop play right away. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can hear a body hit that hard. That's.
And he didn't look like he was going to get up either right away. Okay. Well, it makes me feel better that they both saw it and said it wasn't anything crazy.
Thank you.
Way to get down the floor and get in position for that. It's a good pickup.
Greg's over at another floor. And that kid over there with glasses?
Yeah.
Sitting on the bench?
He was refereeing yesterday. And he's been over there clapping and yelling about the new hosting thing. So Greg's a little concerned.
Which kid?
With the glasses with the hat on backwards.
He was a coach yesterday. Wasn't he?
No, he was an official.
He worked here yesterday?
That's what Greg wants to know. I don't know. Tom did the scheduling. But
he doesn't look like he was here yesterday.
Maybe.
See, there was an official that looked just like him.
Oh.
I said, well, great.
Tom.
I said, I can run and get Tom if you're concerned. He said, well, he's doing a little some things, and he officiated the hosting game yesterday. I went, oh. Well, I said, I don't think Tom, if he has a new hosting address, would put him on the new hosting game.
Probably not.
He probably didn't. But I'll let Tom know. So I'll be right back.
Yeah, this one's going to be right down to the wire, looks like, over there. Yeah. Good rotation out on this, guys. I mean, you guys, honestly, if you want my opinion right now, is you're officiating this second half is much better than the first half. So even though we had that, like, colossal fall, I mean, it doesn't look like there's anything to be had on that play. And it's the kid sitting against the wall with the glasses and a hat on. Was he a camper yesterday? Oh, he's giving the official shit, I guess. Ask Gotti.
Thank you.
watched them making like foot gestures and stuff towards the whole team bench, like that was a foul. Greg had concerns.
Greg's a little bit warmed up today.
Pissed off and
wands,
or I don't know what's
really. Okay. So did I witness anything? No, I just saw him like, you know, a little wider, Kevin, on this play. A little wide, rotate wide out, wide out. Always a pleasure. Always.
I will let her know that. You know, it's too bad this doesn't happen like twice a year, three times a year. We all can get back together and have some fun, but.
Guys, I don't, like I said, the second half, I don't have a lot. You guys are calling the game the way it's supposed to be. You know, good, picking things up. I mean, like, here we go.
job, guys. Good rotation and all that. Good playing through. You got the foul on the lead here. That was good. And then the rotation all rested. The only thing that would kind of make this a little smoother would be the mechanical out of bounds there. Just hit the whistle, point, and then tell your partner where it's going to go. John is now back.
Gosh, it's not much.
No, there hasn't been anything happening at all.
Did that kid come back that got hurt? Scored a basket. Should be 2 points. What's going on?
That was a three.
Oh, there it is. So White must be ahead then.
Make sure all the players are back on the floor, Dylan. Make sure they're all back on the floor.
Yeah.
Okay, we got 1 minute to go. It's 45-32, 6-4, and falls. Since I got back from my little adventure, nothing's really happening. It's all nice rotations. Although Kevin just rotated during a shot. So at about 45 seconds, Kevin, you're the lead, and you rotated during a shot. Final 45-33, 7-4.
And more.
All right.
Good game, guys. Good work.
When you're rotating, Kevin, from, you know, you're on this side, on that end, you rotated during a shot.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Okay, and then what happened right after that?
There's a bunch of...
This gentleman was down, way down here. And the whole rotation was screwy, and you caught it right away. So on a shot, if you're rotating, you're starting here, and you're in the paint, and the shot goes up, go, holy shit.
I didn't know what to do.
In your mind, just back up.
I wasn't watching the ball, and I saw a matchup going across, so I'm like, okay, I'll follow that, like, beat them to it, and then they shot on top, and I'm like, fuck, I don't want to go.
And here's another little tidbit. I see people like this with their chin down. Remember I told you about the waltzing? Okay, now here's another tidbit. Look where my eyes are.